welcome to my review for Ninjago, the Ice Chapter, Episode 2, or as it is also called, Ninjago Secrets of Spinjitzu, Episode 17. But, I'm calling it Episode 2 because it is the Ice Chapter, and I'll get to why in a second. But make sure you like and subscribe as we dive into the Fire Maker episode. So anyway, first up, I just want to say, this season is shaping up to be better than the Fire Chapter in ways. And that's... The Fire Chapter wasn't actually as bad as some people make it out to be, excluding the filler stuff. I exclude the filler as well. I don't count the filler in my final views. That's a separate thing. I completely... Because it's filler, so you don't really need to include... You just forget it. But anyway, basically, this season is good on the case that it is actually probably the first season, and well, actually, it's actually connected to the season. The Fire Chapter and Ice Chapter are one season. However, it feels like it's a separate season to the Fire Chapter. Even though it's the same season, and it is the same season, the way they're set out, it feels like a different season. It doesn't feel like the same season. It's a completely different tone. It's kind of going back to the tone of Season 8. And, like, all that. Like, that whole series with some jokes and some lighthearted parts. But the plot and the story itself is a lot more like Season 8 now. Again. So, it feels like a different season to me. And that's not a bad thing. And a good thing about this one, which makes it better than Season 8, in my opinion. Only this part makes it better. Not in general. Like, Season 8 is still great in other ways. But in this way, it's better than other seasons since being... Because this is the first season, or first chapter, however you want to look at it. Sorry, I know it's one season. I can't help but think they're two different seasons because I feel it. But this is the first chapter and first story for Ninjago that's being solely based outside Ninjago's realm. And that's what's awesome about it. Like this, like every season, even Hunted, which had two realms... And two stories for two different realms. That other realm was kind of still Ninjago based and was a terrible story. The first realm was a terrible other world realm story. This one is the first good story that based outside the realm. And it's the first time Ninjago's actually been at peace. Stayed at peace. Like, it's still at peace right now. Like, they stopped the spear. And, you know, they're actually stopping a plot or protecting people in another realm. And no, Hunted did not have this type of people. Hunted, the first realm was all about, had all dragon hunters. Like, pretty much everyone was out for themselves. There was no people like villagers, like in this season where there's actually villagers who don't usually fight and, like, aren't hunters in a way. Like, it's hard to be. Yes, the dragon hunters are no longer evil and are dragon riders now, as I call them. But this season feels better in story-wise, like, actually they are protecting another, like, they came to this realm for one reason, and now they're basically here, and they're going to probably end up, you know, protecting this realm, saving this realm, and it's good to see something like that finally. Like, it's been so, like, we've never gotten it, like, not really, we've never gotten this, like, it's always been Ninjago in danger, and this is the first time Ninjago's not in danger, and it's all this realm. And that's what I like about it so far. Like, that's what's good. I mean, we don't know what's going to happen. I'm reserving my full judgment for the end of the season. But for this, you know, for what where we're up to now and how it's going, it does feel like a good thing to have a change. It's changed in that way. And I like that. I definitely, you know, I definitely give this episode a 7 out of 10. It's brilliant. It's not brilliant, sorry. It's just really good, and it's a real change to things. Plus, there's a battle scene that's kind of similar to the battle for Winterfell. I know that's a Game of Thrones, and a lot of people probably don't watch that, but I'm sorry, I watched Game of Thrones, so I can't help but to connect them, even though there's no connection. But there kind of is, but there kind of isn't. I mean, the Iron Man kind of remind me of the White Walkers, but at the same time, not. So it's very, and they are corrupted people. It's one of those situations that's like, it's not, there's no connection, but there is a connection. And so every time so while I was watching this battle scene, I almost thought, hey, it's a battle of Winterfell again. You know, the White Walker's coming. It's like, so, you know, it does have that kind of feel. And plus, there was a tweet from one of the co-creators basically mentioning, and it was a Ninjago post, and it kind of mentioned the whole Song of Fire and Ice. So it's like, did they get inspired by Game of Thrones in some way? Because why are you mentioning that? But yeah, no, it's there's no connection, but there is a connection. It's one of those situations. But the tone feels amazing, and I really enjoyed this. I'm really enjoying the season so far, and I hope the thing. Obviously, there's been no filler yet, but expect filler. Like, there is going to be filler, and that will probably diminish the season. Like, for me, the fire chapter was great, but all the filler and stuff like that really took away from the season. And if there is overboard of filler in this season, apart from the anime that's apparently meant to be coming this season, and viewpoint of the villain episode, apparently those two are meant to be happening this season, from what I remember, may take away. The viewpoint of the villain shouldn't, but the anime one will definitely take away from the plot and the story, so I'm really concerned about that. In some ways, it's not that I don't enjoy seeing a different anime style. I'm gonna enjoy seeing the anime style, but it just feels like it's gonna take away from the plot in this if it's in it. So, but yeah, so that's my basically overview with that spoiler-free review. So, yeah. Anyway, moving on. This part right here will now be the spoiler part. So if you don't want to be spoiled, you haven't seen the episode, you know, you can click on this video and, you know, go watch the episode. And yeah. Okay, so now that they're gone, let's get into some spoiler-based stuff. So basically, the episode, as we know, is called The Fire Maker. The reason for that is because Kai does get his powers back towards the end of it. Basically, after the battle of for the village and the, I was going to say White Walkers, the Blizzard Sunrise attack, the general there, which is not General Vex, but another general, he's probably a lieutenant, maybe. He looks like he's the head boss, under Vex, but in that level. Basically, he destroys the fire pit, which is a fire pit that they think that they were just, before the battle, they were debating whether to leave, even or not, because they said that they have actually, that fire's been going for decades. Like, they've been refueling it because it's so hot. They wouldn't be able to remake the fire if it goes out. So, which makes sense. I mean, it's so cold now that it would be kind of difficult. And since Kai didn't have his powers at the time, he couldn't really think. And moving fire is not really the easiest thing. So, basically, that fire's been moved for, burning for decades. And the ice, lieutenant general, whatever he is, destroys it. And then, you know, hope seems lost, mostly. And the Asamways retreat, you know, basically saying they may have won the battle, but they lost the war, which is kind of a old saying. So, you know, they gather around a fire and blankets, you know, cold. The kids basically, there's a kid who's really cold and he says to his mommy's cold. I'm just like, well, yeah, there's no fire and you're in a snow land. Of course it's cold, kid. You know, obviously there, Kai feels, you know, useless because he can't use his powers. Although, before this, the old lady does say, and I always say this, people said that Kai's powers were gone. People kept saying, you know, Kai's powers were gone. And yes, it probably was silly to bring his powers back now, but I'm trying to say, people actually thought his powers were taken. I knew that his powers were still in him, in reality. Like, I knew, because, for one, when Lloyd lost his powers, he got it back. And then the season after, he kept his powers when Garmadon had his powers. So, you know, it's kind of like a mental block that keeps their powers away. After they lose it, they seem to get like a mental block, keeping them from regaining their powers and all that. And it kind of lies dormant. And probably would be better, yes, to have his powers return later in the season. Having it this early, some people thought it was kind of, you know, lame and kind of dumb, and in a way it is, because, you know, it would have been cooler, but at the same time, if he did get his powers back, that village would be kind of doomed. There was really no way to around it after the fire had gone out. So, like, they would have all frozen to death. And I know that's pretty dark, but granted, there are some things in Ninjago that are dark throughout all of season. Through, even back when Pato and Wu got eaten by Devourer, that was pretty dark. So, there is a lot of dark, there is dark throughout all Ninjago, just some more than others. So, anyway. So, obviously, you know, Lani basically, you know, gets him, gets his mental block gone. He then attempts to light fire, and it works, and he has his powers back. Basically, that's how it works. It's really not that hard to explain, and it's really not that much to explain. And yeah, that's basically the episode. And then, obviously, at the end, Vex is there stalking them. I feel like Vex is a stalker. He likes to look in that dark ice mirror and just watch them. He's a stalker. But basically, he gets kind of annoyed because of the thing, and then that basically is the end of the episode. Well, this part of the episode. Or this episode, since they're in 11 minutes. And so, you know, that's basically, you know, episode 17? 16? Well, 17, I think. Can't actually remember. But anyway, that does it. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe, and check back tomorrow for the third episode review of the Ice Chapter. And, you know, the Fire Chapter, as I said, I am working on. In fact, one review for the Ice Chapter, Fire Chapter, should be coming up alongside this. But anyway, as I said, like, comment, subscribe, and yeah. Alright, see ya!